Hello, good morning everybody for joining the webinar. So today the topic is Excel magic. Excel is always a magic if we know the advanced version. So today we have CA Vijay Agarwal as our speaker and he will take us through the session. So before that I'll just hand over the session to CA Sai Devta, our chairman of ICAQA chapter, to introduce and brief on our chapter activity. So before wasting any time, I just hand over to Sai. Sai, over to you.
Yeah, thank you, Rohit. Hope I'm audible, everyone. Rohit, please check.
Yes,
It
you are
audible, right?
audible. Yes, Sai. Yes,
Okay,
you are.
thanks for the confirmation. Yes, a very good morning to all, to the speaker, and today's speaker, Mr. Vijay Agarwal, and all our fellow members who are in Kuwait, and good afternoon to the members who are attending this session from other countries and India as well. Welcome you all to our fourth webinar session, which is after lockdown, and we are under complete lockdown now. So this is a big opportunity for all us to learn and grow. So with the intent of that, we are organizing seminars on a weekly basis. Sorry, webinars. Happy and blessed Ramadan to you and your loved ones. Maybe this blessed month of Ramadan take us this weird situation and very unusual COVID scenario. So as we said, with the intent of this, keeping our members updated with the recent developments and handful of training and everything, we are continuously organizing these webinars for the benefit of CA fraternity at large. In addition, we are also organizing the event details with what other chapters locally and internationally they are doing it. I know it is, we might be bombarding with lot of the flyers and the topics on a regular, on a daily basis, but this is all just because to enhance your knowledge and keep you updated. Since I know that we have the full curfew now, so it is better time, and so turn this crisis into an opportunity to enhance your knowledge and grow. Also, ICA has updated the online digital learning hub portal, so wherein all the members can access and register for their online courses like ISA and blockchain technology, international taxation, diploma and IFRS. So there are a lot of so many courses. If you visit the online digital hub, so definitely there is a, it gives a lot of mileage for you to enhance and grow with money and many more degrees. So coming to this, in terms of the today's topic, we brought our SME. He is very familiar in Excel, and definitely he has done a lot of webinars and seminars across all other countries, and recently has done in GCC chapter. So with the intent of that, we have got a very good response. So we, our Deepak Bindal, secretary, he has approached and he said like we should have this same webinar to our members and everything. So like last year we did with our members, CA Suresh, CA Suresh. So we want to continue the same sort of every year with the Excel. So that's the reason we invited our CA Vijay here. So in terms of the, I just give a brief overview of the Vijay's profile without much taking of his time. So Mr. Vijay Agarwal is a big data analyst and automation expert. He's also a chartered accountant and company secretary with almost 20 years of experience. He is currently a freelancer providing Excel solutions and trainings to corporates, institutes, and automating processes by using Excel and BI tools. Also, he does the PowerPoint training. So I think we should have one more section on the PowerPoint. It is very much required. And Microsoft awarded Most Valuable Professional for award for the almost 4 years consecutively from 2014 to 2018. Less than 10 VBs, MVPs, less than 100 MVPs in the world. Microsoft invited their headquarters at Redmond, USA for 4 years during this award period. He previously worked with Telenor, Capgemini, Aircel, and Jindal's, Havells, etc. There is a lot to read out. Had three webinars for ICA in 2016, each one attended by more than 2,000 CAs, and he was a faculty for ICA Forensic and Fraud Detection Program as well. He runs the website and YouTube channel with the brand name Champ Excel. So, like, in terms, if the members have missed it, or if you feel that you have been not attended some of the session and all in between, but yes, definitely you can go and log into the Champ Excel, the YouTube channel. Definitely there are a lot of lessons and you can go and keep on learning there. And he has done Excel seminars for corporate groups, which are more than 200 workshops, and ICA Faridabad, more than 25 seminars he has done. And in ICA North India branches, Gurgaon, Amritsar, Ludhiana, their name is unlimited. ICA Trivandrum as well, and ICA Parshadnagar. And he also had corporate clients naming from PwC, HTML, Gale. So there is a list is never ending. So with this, I really welcome Mr. CA Vijay Agarwal to host the session. For this, I also welcome Deepak Bindal to moderate the session, and also if any members has any questions, so they can post the questions in the Q&A tab, which will be answered by the speaker at the end of the session. So he will be going with his own pace, and don't feel that you are lost or anything. We are recording the session and we'll be publishing the session. The video recording will be shared with all the members, and also the Excel, the worksheet, what Mr. Vijay is doing it, that also will be shared with you, with all the members. And we have a very good audience, definitely more than 100 plus audience now. So I feel this is a very informative and knowledgeable session to all the members. So without much ado, I would like to welcome CA Vijay Agarwal to take control of the webinar. Thank you. Over to you, Mr. Vijay.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Sai. First of all, I am very thankful to Kuwait ICI chapter for inviting me to interact, to share my knowledge regarding whatever I know little bit about Excel. Friends, there was a very good response from Dubai chapter also. And also I am very, very much thankful to Mr. Deepak. So I'm interacting with him for last few days or few weeks, I can say. And lot of things like we are exchanging in between, lot of knowledge sharing, lot of like things like how the things are moving in Kuwait or Dubai or UAE. So he wanted to have that, okay, there should also, like the magic of Excel should also go in Kuwait. So I'm always ready because I'm very, very passionate about Excel. And that's why like I have left my job. So more than 22 years, I have worked with different organizations and on different portfolios. But since beginning, what was there that, okay, I was very, very passionate about Excel, about computers, about SAP. So I always looked that, okay, how the things happen so fast in computer? Why it is we can't do so? So what is behind this? So I always a little smart to know things better. And that's why I am on this platform today. Friends, anybody with small like smartness, like little like extra, like if you are going to put efforts, so definitely within few days, you can also become a smart user of Excel. And the people are going to come you, you are very good in Excel. Please help me out. So such type of comment, you can always listen. So friends, let me start to share my screen and let's start the magic of Excel. So please, I'll request Mr. Deepak, our moderator. In between, so please tell me that, okay, everything is going fine. So sometimes like it happens that, okay, like if there is some interruption or some something like my voice or screen is not visible. So please keep calm. So maybe sometimes because of technology, maybe that few seconds, like we are disconnected or maybe there is a delay, but definitely we are there and definitely we are going to complete all the magics of Excel. So that I can assure you, sir.
Sure, we will. Yeah. I will.
So I believe you are able to see my screen, sir.
Yes, Mr. Vijay.
Okay, great. Very good. So let's move to the this magic journey of Excel.
Keeping a full slide view. Sorry.
Yeah, please.
Yes.
So Excel, I'm having talk with the ICI like chairman nowadays. So this Sri Atul Gupta ji also, like other CC members also. So I always we had a lot of discussion. Sometimes like we shared the platform also on some seminars also. So I always I said one thing to them that like whatever study we people are doing, accounts, be it company law, be it income, I'm not sure whether that study is going to be work out in your practical life or not. Maybe like after doing your CA, you are into some business. Maybe you are into practice, maybe you are doing some job. So it depends like which line you are going to have. And maybe one or two subjects, maybe not at all you are going to use. But there is one thing that is certain. That is certain from day one. Like if you are good in Excel, if you know little extra knowledge of Excel, then definitely that thing is going to work out. Whether you go in any field, whether it is a business, whether you are going to higher study, whether you go for practice or any job, anywhere, this is going to work out. So that's why, like, I always wanted to have institute that, okay, sir, which our members are doing. So we are not able to the power of Excel. And regarding Excel, like, there is a, this is my own quote. So there is a quotation, like, I always say that Excel is an aeroplane. Excel is an aeroplane. And we people, we are using this aeroplane like a cycle, right? And if you are using as a cycle, then it's okay. Still, I'm glad that, okay, you are using as a cycle, or maybe you are, at least you are going. But sometimes what happens, we are not using that cycle. We are carrying that cycle even on our shoulders. So we are doing mistakes, and then we are doing some manual things. So such type of things should not happen. So friends, this is really, really magic, and you will be, everybody knows, there may be like any product you can take, that may be the fan, that may be the mobile, that may be the laptop, everywhere you are going to find the competition. But from last 20 years, since 1998, like if you see, Excel is only Excel. It's not that, okay, you can use, apart from Excel, some other product. Yes, for last 2-3 years, there is a Google Sheet is there. But for last 20 years, there is the monopoly of Excel. Whichever country is there, whichever language is there. So such a wonderful product we are having about this Excel. So why should not we have the power of this Excel? Why don't we understand the power of this Excel? So today, I'm going to have this. Why the need of data analytics is there? Why we should have the knowledge of Excel? So why, that is the thing, like it, the days has gone of earlier days that, okay, we were having the traditional practice. We were having the staff with us. But today it's a like era of technology. Today, like it's a era of very millions of rows. Today it's a era of like having the multiple clients. And it's a era of like the quick reporting. So in this era, if we are not going with the technology, so definitely we are out. Definitely then our like juniors, maybe the new person, so they are going to replace our like things, our like practice. So nowadays you see, there is no limitation, no boundary, no country. We are having Amazon, Ola, Make My Trip, such type of things. They are having business all over the world, like sitting on the home or sitting at one place, and they are having the business. Millions of rows nowadays analyzed. I remember when I was in 2013, when I in Excel, there were just 65,000 rows. So I used to like think that why 65,000 rows? Like anybody can use 65,000 rows. So I think that, okay, 2,000, 5,000, that is more than enough. But today we are having in Excel more than 1 million rows. Still we feel that 1 million is very less. We need maybe 10 millions, maybe like 2 crores, 5 crores, such type of things are there. Dynamic reporting. Nowadays, we need reporting. Like if my boss is going to ask me that, okay, I need some report. So I say that, okay, when do you require? So boss say, I required it yesterday. You know, you are already late. I need it today itself. So that type of reporting, like nowadays in this competitive environment, we are having such type of thing. Then different analytical reports with same data, like the data is same. But our like stakeholders are different. So sometimes we are having our company CEO. Sometimes we are having the company CFO. Sometimes our auditors. Sometimes our like debtors, some clients. So in that case, our data. And when the reports comes and when we are going to compare something, then there is some like issue, because the understanding difference, because of the like copying, there is some like some mistake is there. So in that case, the work is also going to increase. At the same time, the reports is also not correct. So how to make the same data different reports? and quick MIS and decisions. If our MIS will be quick, if we are quick in giving the reports to our management, then the decisions will be fast and our company will grow. If our company will grow, then definitely our growth will also be there. Confidentiality, like sometimes what happens that, okay, like we don't want to share the data, but if we are having data, if we don't know how to analyze the data, then what to do? Anyway, we have to share the data, but if we are sharing, our confidentiality goes. But if we know the Excel, if we know such type of wonderful tools, then definitely we can do very quick, within minutes, within like a couple of hours, we can create a lot of good dashboard, good reporting, good charts, good this organization chart, anything we can create. So all those such things, like I know that the time is very, very short. Like we are having the session of 2 hours and even question answer session also. But still, I'll try my best that, okay, I give you a glimpse of the Excel that, okay, what type of things which you people are not aware. So here, let's start magic of these tips and tricks. So you go with my flow. You try to go with my flow, try to understand, because you are going to have this recording also with you. So no worry, you can repeat it, you can watch it. So first thing, which I always come whenever I am going to have some chapter, some corporate trainings or whatever things, that is, I'll tell you that, okay, how to do this copy paste. The people say, oh, you are telling that you are an international trainer. So you are going to tell us copy paste. No. We know copy paste very well. Every day, most of the times, 40% times, 50% times, what we do? We are always doing this copy paste only, control C, control V. What is in that? But I say, no, friends, today I'm going to tell you smart copy paste. How this smart copy paste is going to work, let's understand that. Let's take some one file and try to understand what is the smart copy paste in Excel. Is it going fine, Deepak ji? In between, please, because I'm not able to see the screen. So in between, you please tell me that everything is going fine.
Yeah, continue, please.
Very good, sir. So friends, we are having like some data. So here in this data, what I'm having this data from different departments. I'm having the departments like the R&D department. I'm having the data from finance department. I'm having the data from operation department. I'm having the data from HR department. Right now, there are only four seats. There may be four files. There may be 20 files. The data size may be one can be 100 rows. The other can be 10,000 rows. So in that case, if we are sitting on a corporate office, we are sitting on a head office, what will be our requirement? What my manager would like to have? Definitely, the answer will be that, okay, I want to append the data. I want to consolidate the data. I want to create a like totality report that like my manager wants to see that what is the total budget as a whole, as a company. So definitely, what is the way we do that? Okay, we know the traditional way. What is our traditional way? We go here and control C, and on a new sheet or new file, control V. And then again we go. Now we are smart, such smart we all are there that, okay, header is same. Let's take only the this data, control C, and here we go, control V. Right? So when we are doing such type of things, there may be sometimes that interruption is there. Maybe we are getting some phone calls. Maybe sometimes if we are getting a call from our wife, then definitely our balance will go here and there. Yes, for me, it happens that, okay, like I'll forget that, okay, I don't know that how many copy I have done. So what we are doing, I'm doing this copy paste, copy paste, copy paste, such type of thing I'm doing. But while doing it, maybe some one file I can forget, or maybe something I have done twice. And also it is taking time, like something is lying on the ground floor, I'm on the third floor, I'm taking one bag on third floor, I'm going, coming down, again, coming, going down. So if such type of things, I'll say that, okay, why don't you do copy, 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 copy. First you do all the copies, and once you have done this, let's do the paste all. Whether that will be smart way or not? What do you say, Deepak ji? Will it be smart?
No, this is not smart. If we copy all and then paste, yeah, it is a smart way.
Yes, that will be a smart way. Right. So now how to see? Now the question comes that, okay, like if I do some copy and if again I'm going to do copy, again I'm going to do copy, what will be in my memory? Deepakji, what will be in my memory?
All copies should be there.
No, but that like my members, like if I'm going to ask, so that will be the last in memory, because whatever I have copied in last, that will be in my memory, obviously. Then I feel that, okay, something if I have copied twice, a third time, so like the my previous copies has gone. That is our belief system. But come out that belief system. Why? Because we are chartered accountants. We should see that, okay, what is the things? One key you use every day. What is that key? That is control Z. Something you are doing some mistake, so you delete. Now you say that, okay, in Excel memory, only the last thing is there. But when you do control Y, if there is only last thing, it should come only once. But if I'm going to...
Vijayji, the voice and the video has stopped. There is a pause. Hello.
Hello. My voice is coming.
Yeah, now it's okay. It got paused for few seconds before.
Okay.
So, yeah, you need to share the screen again.
Okay, this is the thing, like I'm okay. No, but it's showing me that, okay, already like the screen is shared like by me. So should I stop sharing and then should I again share the screen?
Yeah.
Yes, stop sharing and again share it.
Okay. Is it fine, sir? Now is it okay?
Now it's fine, yeah.
Are you able to? Okay, great. So what was my thing that what I want to tell you that, okay, if I'm going to copy and copy, then how I can do that? So for that, friends, we have to understand that we have to go here and let's see. This is our ribbon. So it is having lot of commands, but hardly we use only 5% of these commands. Hardly we use only 8% of commands. So why all these commands are there? Why, for which, whom, like Microsoft has made it? So we feel ourselves, we think that, okay, those commands are for maybe some like Excel expert, maybe for some NASA people, maybe for some like ISRO people. So if that type of thing, we should not never think. So let's go to the first ribbon. That is the home ribbon, home tab. Here, if we go to this clipboard, so in clipboard, when I'm going to click, right now this clipboard is empty. So once I click this clipboard, it is activated. Now if I go here and if I'm going to do copy, so my first clipping is copied. If I go to the second copy, my second clipping is copied. If I go to the third, and if I'm going to copy again, third clipping is copied. And like that, fourth clipping is also copied. So now the fourth clipping has been copied. And what I can do, I can go to some new sheets, new files, and there, what I can do, friends, here if you see, there is a button, which is the name of paste all. So now all the clippings are available here. And once I click this button of paste all, automatically my all clippings will be available. Everything will be copied at one go. Like this is the 1 second, third and fourth. That's why I have given different colors. So that is the smart way of copying, smart way of appending the data. And the best thing about this, you will feel that, okay, this is Excel. Whether it will happen in all the files, yes, it will happen all the files, not only in Excel. It will be available in Word also. If you go to the Word, like that is the like Word, and your Excel is closed, friends, your Excel is closed after half an hour, and you are doing some work in Word, and that time you say that, okay, something like you remember, oh, I need to paste my data of the this R&D department here. So what you can do here also in Word, there is also clipboard. Here in this clipboard, you are also having this. If you are going to click single, so you see that is also available here. If you click here, that is also available there. So that means this clipboard is shared across the Microsoft family. If you are going to copy something from Word, that will be available Excel as well as Word in the PowerPoint also. So such type of things like you can use. That is old smart copy paste. Now what is the learning? You will say that, okay, our learning is that we have learned the smart copy paste if you go. No, no, no. That is not the learning. I always believe in giving and not giving fish. Instead of that, we should try to do the fishing. How to do the fishing? So here the learning is not the smart copy paste, but the learning is that we should explore all these products, like all these things that, okay, there are so many things. When we go here, when we go this drop down, then always these are treasures. We should try to find out those things. Something like if you want to find out. So like that, if you go here, we find out that there is a clipboard. Like you see, there is an underline. If your boss says, I want something like double underline is not there. But if you go, if you try exploring the thing, and you will find there is a drop down. When you click this drop down, there is double underline is also there. Feel the magic. So such type of things are lying since 15 years, but we are not using. So here, if I'm going to use this double underline, so that is also going to work double underline. Sometimes, like I don't know what is all these ribbon is there. You know that, okay, this is the bold. You know that, okay, this is the filter. So everything like you know. But there are so many commands. We don't know how to know all these things without any training, without any such going to internet. There is a very smart way. When you are going here and when you are going to hold your cursor here for half a second, you are going to get the comment. Like when you go here and you put cursor here, so it is telling you that what is the bold, what is the shortcut key for that, right? When you go to data, you don't know the shortcut key for filter. So you can go here, hold the, your cursor here and see, it is telling that filter, control shift L is the shortcut key. So like that, any key, like you can know the shortcut key. Anything which you are not aware, you can know the things. When you are home, you can go here. What is this conditional formatting? Hold your cursor and it is going to give you commentary. So every day, if you are going to learn one thing, two things, in within 30 days, there will be 25 new commands will be there. Obviously, you are going to get edge for that. So such type of things, actually the learning, that is the fishing, not a fish. So that thing, that learning, you should take after this webinar. So if you want to clear this, so we can clear all, and that is gone. Right? I can close this, that's all. So now the second thing which I want to tell, that okay, what is, there is a very good feature of custom list. What is that custom list here? Like you know, there is a name Jen, and if I say that, okay, and if I'm going to drag it, what it is going to give? It is going to give me all the months, March, April, right? The same way, if I'm going to write Jen, and if I say that I'm going to drag, what it will give? I'm 100% sure, more than 90% of my members, my colleagues, my friends, they are going to say it will be Jen only. But you are absolutely wrong. So here, if we are going to drag, even with a month, it is going to give me Jan, Feb, March. Even if I'm going to drag right side, that is also going to give. So this is called a custom list. This custom list is made by Microsoft. That is the by default. But suppose we want to make this custom list ourselves, maybe for our employees, maybe for our branches, maybe for our products, maybe for our anything, any requirement. So that is also very easy possible. And that custom list is going to work in all your files, whether your old files or your new files. How to do that? You go to file. You go to option. In option, there is a thing. This is like a setting button of your mobile phone where you can do the customization. So here in your customization, you go to advanced. And in advanced, there are a lot of commands. I'm just giving a very, very short tips. But you have to explore all these things, friends. All these things you have to explore. So once you go like here, and then on the last, So you are going to find edit custom list. You see, in advance, there is an edit custom list. So when you click on this edit custom list, these are the custom lists you find here. So these are the lists which are part of the Excel. These are gray out. You can't change it. You can't delete it. You can create a new list. You can have this type of list. Here, what we can do, we can create new list. Suppose you want to create list of your like cities. Okay, you say that, okay, your Dubai is there. You say that, okay, Sharjah is there. You say that Ajman is there. You say that Abu Dhabi. You say that Delhi, New York. So whatever like cities you are having, so you are put here. Whatever sequence trends you are going to put, whatever spelling you are going to put, whatever material code that can be complicated, that you are going to put. So here, this is only one-time work. You can even import, you can import also here. So when you are here, you can create 50 name list. You can create 500 name list. Once it is there, you add it. After adding, what will happen? This list will be permanent. This list will be permanent. And that will be, that is okay. That is okay. Now, what is the benefit of this? Now, the benefit of this is whether you are on new file, whether you are on old file, whether you are on like after 1 year, or whether you are going next second. If you are going to put here some name, okay, you are going to select that, okay, that is the Delhi. Now, if you want to drag it, Delhi, Dubai is there. Now, you want to drag the Dubai to right side, that is also there. Now, you want to put this Sharjah on top of it, that is also there. So, these type of custom lists you can create. The same sequence, whatever you want, whatever you have given, same spelling it is going to give, and very flexible. This is available in new file also, your old file also. Anytime you can use these, and you can edit also, you can delete also. So that is the thing which I want to tell you. That is the custom list which you can create. Now, let's friend go to the magic of Flash Field. That is the one of the key which I love like anything. Really, once you come to know, you will also get into love of it. That is the Flash Field. That is a Flash Field. What is this Flash Field? Flash Field. But friends, for this, you have to make some investment. What is that investment? I know my friends, they are using Excel of 2007. I know my friends, those are using of Excel 2010. And when I ask them, why you are using Excel 2007? No. Our work is going well. We are okay. Work was going on with your this mobile phone of the Nokia phone 3310 in the era of 2000. That was also fine. Why you are using the smartphone? Why you are using the iPhone? Why you are using the very costly phone, price of 1 lakh rupees? So why? Because you want to use the WhatsApp, because you want to book the Ola, because you want to control the like everything. You want to use the YouTube. So that is not possible in the old phone. In the same way, there are lot of new things has come in the books of Excel also. So friends, I will suggest you should also go with the latest Excel. Latest Excel, after 2007, it was 2010, 2013, 2016, 2019 also come. And the latest one is Office 365 or Microsoft 365. That is the latest thing. You should always go with Office 365. You are always going to have the latest version, latest command. This Flash Field is a part of Microsoft Excel 2013 or onwards after that. So if you are having 2010 or 7, please, excuse me, this magic is not for yours. Go this magic. I believe. So can we mute the voice? There is some disturbance is coming. Hello? Yeah, now it's fine. Deepakji, are you able to hear me?
Yes, I am able to hear you. And I think if everyone mute themselves, it will be more clear.
Yeah, yeah. Please, I also request, because even a single person, so who is unmuted, so definitely it is going to create problem for all the members. So it's my like personal request. So please mute yourself, everyone, so that we can take this. We can enjoy this magic of Excel. Thank you. So now, what is the Flash Fill? Flash Fill is the artificial intelligence. You know, nowadays the hottest topic of like in industry in IT, that is the artificial intelligence. That is the machine learning, the automation. That is the thing. So Microsoft has given this artificial intelligence to Excel in 2013, 7 years back. But still we are not using it. But still we are not aware of it. Even I know so many people, they are having the latest Excel, but still they are not aware. So by keeping latest Excel, it doesn't mean that, okay, they are aware of everything, right? If you are going to have some yoga book with you, it doesn't mean that, okay, you are healthy. Your tummy is like very good. So it's not like that. So just by keeping something is different, and doing something that is also different. So here, what is this magic key of this Flash Fill? Let's understand this. So here, like something, by using this magic key, friends, you can do maybe your hours work, maybe for days work, you can do in seconds. I'm talking about seconds. Maybe one day work, you can do maybe in few seconds. That is the magic of this Flash Fill. How? It depends on the quantum of data. Like maybe you are having the data like this. You are having, there is no comma, no full stop, no space, no delimiter. This is single word. And in this single word, you are having the numbers also. Now your boss asks that, okay, I need numbers in a different column, the hello in different column, or the third one is also in a different column. Now this is a pain point. Maybe some of the members will feel, yes, we can do it with the help of text to column. No way, you can't do with the help of text to column, because there is a limit, no delimiter. For doing text to column, there should be some space, there should be some comma or full stop, but that is not there. So that is the manual thing. If you are going to do it manual, definitely there will be mistake. If you are having 50,000 entries, maybe you are going to spend full day. Maybe like you are not going to have the like food of your of the hand of your wife. Are you getting my point? So maybe you are having the food of your market. So in that case, what to do? How this artificial intelligence is going to work? So friends, that intelligence is lying in the data. In data, where it is lying? It is lying on the text to columns. I told you in beginning that, okay, we have to explore all these buttons. These are the treasures. This is the text to column. When we put cursor, it will give me that, okay, what is this? So because you are not having time, you are having time, we are having time for WhatsApp, we are having time for Facebook, we are having time for everything, but we are not having time for Excel. But Excel is going to make our life easy. Excel is going to give us more clients. So if we go here, so if you go here, you put here cursor, so it is giving me Flash Fill. What is the Flash Fill? What is the shortcut? That is the Control E. So friends, if you want to learn this magic, always remember Control E. Automatically fill in values, enter a couple of example, right? So automatically it will do without any help, without any formula. So you give just like a kid, you telling, so you just put 12. And now, anywhere you go here and tell Excel, I want the magic of your power and artificial intelligence. Click Control E. Wow, that's a wonderful. It's wonderful. It's not only giving numbers. If you want, buy. And then if you are going to click Control E. Wow, that is also wonderful. So instead of that, you want that, okay, I want buy underscore hello underscore 12. And if I go here, Control E, that is also possible. So that type of thing is there. Here the name is there. You want that, okay, I want it, V. Agarwal. You give only one example, two examples. You go here, Control E, that is going to give you. That is automatically it is going to, you want to have the last character, Agarwal, Control E, that is also there. You have in the names, last name, first name, you want to convert. In that case, we need lot of formulas, lot of manual work. Forget all these things. Forget. Just think, if you would have known it 7 years back, how much your life would have been easy, how much precious time you have saved. But anyway, something like anything like we are doing, that is the great beginning. So now you can have Behel Sapna. So here we are saying that, okay, last name first and first name after that. Control E. Wonderful. But stop, sir. There is something mistake. What is that mistake? Oh, I know what you are saying. You are saying here Deepak Kumar Brijwasi, here Narendra D. Modi. So we are not having the D here. We are not having the Kumar here. What is the solution for that? Friends, we have told Excel that, okay, we are having the two character, two word name. So now the requirement has changed. Give the new requirement to Excel. You go here and you go and tell head, okay, F2. Once you do F2, you tell where you want this Kumar. You want Kumar on the last, on the beginning, or in the mid. So you decide it and you put here Kumar. Now see the beauty, see the intelligence. Now, once you are going to put enter, see what will happen. Wonderful. That's something wonderful. Automatically, it has corrected the Narendra. It has corrected the this also. All the names have been corrected. That's something amazing. That I never thought of. So like that, there are so many examples, friends. Like we are having even four columns are there. I can create a single column with the help of this. What is that? I can put, we purchased 15 laptops in Jan from Vijay. You give and ask, apply the artificial intelligence. Now you go here, control E, that is also possible. This is something wonderful. This is something amazing. So it is going to work on numbers also. It is going to, like if you want to remove some numbers also, that is also possible. So anywhere, whatever you want, some complex examples are also there. So that is also going to work here. So anything, anywhere you want to do it, so that is going to work. So if you see one example for numbers, like you are having this extract only numbers. You see, you are having these numbers. So here you want that, okay, I want to have a 10 digit number, no space, no bracket, no dash, no equal to anything, nothing I want. You see, if you have to do it manually, how much time it will take? No formula, nothing. Within second, whether you are having 5 items or 5 lakhs items, it won't make any difference, not at all. Just give some example, 98206101 40. And once you do it, you come here, anywhere you put control E, that's all. That's the magic of Flash Film. I am having lot of examples, but because of time constraint, I am just giving you idea that, okay, even you can remove the space that okay, this is not correct. So too many spaces. So all such type of things you can do here within seconds, like this is not correct. And you say control E, automatically it is going to work. So you please do the examples and you do the practice. I'll share this file with you. You do the practice with my data, with your data. Sometimes if it doesn't work, try to understand the magic, try to understand the logic, try to understand the pattern. And if it is not understanding, give him second pattern, give him third. So it will understand with the help of two examples, three examples, and it will correct your answers. So that is all about the Flash Film. Now let's move to the other magic. So today all magics you are going to see. Conditional formatting magic. So easy to analyze big data. What is this conditional formatting? That is also, let's see. Let's understand how this conditional formatting is going to work. So here, friends, we are having some data. So in this data, I want to see that, okay, I want to find out who got the maximum marks, who got the minimum marks. So if in that case, it's very tough to find out those things. But in case you are going to use this magic of Excel, you just go here, you just select the data, home, go to conditional formatting, and you can say highlight sales value which are greater than which 190. And what is the color? Green color. Okay, automatically it will find out and it will see if I'm going to change the numbers, automatically more than 190, it will create green color. In the same way, I can do the red color also for the lesser numbers. So I can say that, okay, less than 110, red color. See the magic. Immediately you are going to change, automatically you are going to get the answer. It's not only work on numbers. Sometimes you are having the lot of your data. You want to see, is there any duplicate bill number? Is there any name which is coming twice? If there is a person who has taken two times salary. So in that case, maybe you are having 10,000 names, 10,000 code, and you want to see, is there any duplicate? Very easy. What to do? Just you go here, you go to select data, conditional formatting, highlight cell rules, and say duplicate values. What will happen? Automatically it will see duplicate. But right now there is no color of duplicate. Why? There is no duplicate. If I go here and I put here, okay, something like duplicate Disha. Both are duplicate. I put here name of sign. And if again, if I'm going to put, that is going to be duplicate. So in that case, what you do, don't even select data, select your column. Maybe you are having like 10,000 of lines. Just select the column, go here, conditional formatting, click highlight cell rules and duplicate value. Immediately it is going to give you color. And then, you know, with the help of filter, you can filter on the basis of color. You can find out the exceptional items. You can take the action. You can do the correction. So all such type of things are now easy job. So you can use this power of conditional formatting. It's not only conditional formatting that okay, you have to do this thing only. So there also, like, you want to create some pattern, some icon sets. So here, like, you are having different companies, and you want to see that, okay, who is making profit, who is the highest. So you can put icon sets, and you can put like this. Immediately you see, if we are going to present our data in such type of things, if we are going to have analyze data, so it is very quick analysis is there. But if you are going to go with the traditional way, then it really, really very difficult. Then we can't survive in such era. So you see, if I'm going to change numbers, automatically it is changing the pattern. Highest number, green color. Lowest number, red color. Otherwise, in between, there are three categories. It has distributed as per data, the lowest number and the highest number. So like we distribute our property, if we have three sons, so it is going to distribute in three equal proportion. If you want to change the proportion, that is also possible. If you go here, you can say that, okay, green color more than 90% value. So it is having, that should be the green. Otherwise red also, that is very, very flexible. You can create bar also. If you go here in conditional formatting, you say that, okay, I want to create some bar. Some beautiful bar. So, as per number, if you change the number, you see that because this is the highest number, this is taking the maximum color. Now, if you want to see that, okay, how it is working, let's see. You are putting 500, you are putting 480. And now, after that, if you are dragging it, you see, step by step, 500, 480, 460, and like that, it is reducing the color. So there are so many ways. It's not that conditional formatting. I can have a training on conditional formatting for one day, 8 hours, 10 hours training only on conditional formatting. I can have a training on flash fill maybe for one day. I can have lot of examples, lot of business scenarios. But for that, we need time. For that, we need patience. So in that case, so today, our motive is just to make you aware that, okay, such type of things are possible, which are available in new scenarios or old scenarios or all these things. So now, friends, let's move to the next thing. Conditional formatting, so easy to analyze big data. And there are lot of new things are there. Consolidate, this is the old command, but hardly 1% of the people are using. It's so easy for the chartered accountants, who want to compare the data, who wants to consolidate the data, who wants to see that, okay, they are having the four types of budgets are there. Budgets is there, actual is there, some forecast is there, and they want to compare the data, and without help of formula. But no one is using, because everything we have left for the NASA, everything we have left for the ISRO. that type of things, actually all these buttons, everything is important, everything is like good for the good for us. So we have to use all these things, friends. Deepak, are you able to hear my awaz? Are yes. you able to see my screen perfectly? Yes. Fine. Is it going yes. fine?
Yeah, yeah. Let's see an example on conditional consolidation.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, okay. So let's see. So here, let's see the example. I am having the two companies. I am having the trial balance. I am having the trial balance as on 31st when we audited the balance sheet, when we signed the balance sheet. And after signing the balance sheet, we came next year. Now we want to start our audit. These were the closing balances. These were the opening balances. These were the opening balances. So what is the this duty of the auditor? Being an auditor, my first and foremost duty before going to start audit, compare the closing balance which I signed with the opening balance which are coming into the books. Right? So now by seeing here, both are telling that, okay, this trial balance is also tallied. This trial balance is also tallied. But I want to see whether absolutely this is perfectly fine or not. So what to do? Whether we should use some complex VLOOKUP formula, whether we should some index formula, or we should manual? No way. We should. We can use the power of consolidate. That is also in the data tools. In data, there are wonderful things. Because of time, I am not able. Advanced filter, I can spend 2 days on advanced filter. People know about filter. When that question comes from the advanced, they every day they ask, we want to learn advanced Excel. We want to learn advanced Excel. And something Excel is saying that this is advanced. They are not able, they don't want to learn that. For them, that is for NASA, that is for ISRO. Are you getting my point? So here, this is the consolidate key. So what this consolidate is going to do? Let's remove whatever the earlier. So I'll take some new example here. So here, you want that, okay, where to you want to do this consolidation. So I want to do consolidation here. I want to do comparison here. So for that, your header should be same. Particular should be same, but your this name should not be same. If this is same, then both will be consolidated, both will be added. But if you want to compare, there should be some little difference here. But this should be absolutely same header. So now you want this is our like cursor where I want to the making the list. So now you go here and you say that, okay, what is my reference? My reference is with header, I have given this add. This is one list I have added. I'm adding the second list. This I have selected and I have added the second list. And that is also I have put add. So this is my second list. So two lists I have added. Like that I can add three. I can add 30. Any number of lists I can add. I can consolidate or comparison also. Now after doing this, use labels in top row as well as left column. Once you have put this left column and top row, just you go here and click OK. Wonderful. What it is doing? What it has done? Oh, that is something amazing. I never thought about that. 31st March is there. 1st April is there. And deferred tax was part of this data or this data. But deferred tax is not in this table. That means here is zero. And here is the this. Oh, automatically. That is something amazing. I am impressed. So if I want to see the difference, I go here minus and see the difference. Oh, so now it is showing me. And if I'm going to see that total of this, if I want to see the total of this, what should I do? There is also a shortcut key. Maybe I know some of you are going to do sum and you are going to drag like this. No. In that case also, what we can do, we can use Alt equal to, that is a short smart key, but that will stop where there is a blank. So in that case, if still you want to use a smart key of Alt sum, so what you can do, at one go, you can select all the data. And after selecting data, just press Alt equal to. And this is the total. Automatically, you are going to get the total. That is something you are not aware that, okay, Alt equal to is something very, very great. Automatically it has put the total. So now you can take the action. You can ask the management why there is a difference, what happened. So this is the magic of consolidation. Let's move to the other magic. I told you shortcut to sum, alt equal to. So this alt equal to is a great key. So it's not only for sum. You can make sum of multiple columns, multiple rows at one go. Single click to make a chart. Single click and I can make a chart. How that can? No, that we have never heard. Single click and chart. Something that is something amazing. So friends, let's say you are having this data. Jan, Feb, March. You are having this data. Now, what you want to do? You want to create chart. So first thing, when you are going to create chart, first you are going to select the data. That may be the very bigger data. You will go from here to there. Then you will go insert. Then you are going to find out some chart. Which chart? Okay, there is some chart. Okay, I want to make some chart. That is this bar chart. And here you have made this chart. Okay, that is apple or mango or orange or this. So like that, instead of that you want to make for January, that also you can make. So that is January, February, March. So you just switch row column. That is also possible. So now this is chart for January. And here this is the color for apple, mango, orange and grapes. But you this made manually. But do you believe that, okay, this can be done with the magic key? I'll say that, okay, please friends, you try to learn the shortcut keys. It will make your life very easy. It will create a lot of power in your hand. And it is very easy to understand. I'll share with you a file of the shortcut keys. There are a lot of shortcut keys, very easy. What we shortcut key call, everybody knows there is a shortcut key control S, control P, control B. But these are the things which we know. But there are hundreds of keys are there. At least you remember every day one new key. It's not something very big. So now if you want to make, don't need to select the data. Keep your cursor anywhere. And there is a key. And the key name is Alt and F1. F1. F1 means function key. This is the key. Alt and F1. That is the key. Alt and F1. So now, how this is going to work in my case, Alt and F1? Let's see. When I'm going to select this data, friends, right? So if I'm going not select, I'm going to put cursor. And if I'm going to put Alt F1. Oh, amazing. Deepak ji, how you find it?
You saved a lot of time for me now. Amazing.
So you see, and that's going to work wonderfully. And it's not that, okay, again, like if I'm doing this, so it is giving me like this type of thing. Now the thing comes that, okay, this is apple, mango, orange, and this is for Jan, Feb, March is there. And friends, now suppose you want to add data here for April or December. What will you do? Your December is lying here. And now you want to create data for that also. What should we do?
Just add one more column.
So one column we are going to use. But you never know the magic. What is the magic of this? Do you know the copy paste? Do you know copy paste, right?
Yes.
So we can also do the copy paste here. Okay, what to do? We can copy this data, control C. Okay, and keep our cursor anywhere on the chart, anywhere on the chart, and just go here and control V. You see?
Fantastic.
So we never thought that, okay, copy paste we can do in chart also. So I can put like such type of things. I'm having the data of April also. I can put control C and in the same way I go here and I can put something April also. So right now like it has taken like April here, but that something like work. So sometimes what happens, I want to have the data like this January, I want to have the March, I want to have the December. I am selecting this, and if I am going to put Alt 1 and Alt F1, so if I am going to select this data, and if I am going to put Alt F1, so immediately it is going to give me this chart. And sometimes if I want to drag the data, I want to have some other data here, something like I have copied here, and again I want to copy, and I go here, control V, so that also going to give me April data here. This type of amazing things actually we can do, like control C, control V is going to work on our chart also. Please try to explore all these things. These are very, very important. Never worry. It's not that you are learning to how to fly an aeroplane. There is a risk. There is no risk. If something will happen, just close your file. At least you will come to know. You do experiment from today itself, from right now. Just now start doing the magic. Now, how to add new data into a chart? That already I have told you. How to make organization chart in 1 minute? I know this type of problem I have seen. I have seen people who are the PA to the company CEO, who are the very good paymaster, like pay capacity. Like they are getting a very high pay. And the company CEO says that, okay, I want to create some organization chart. What it means, I want to create an organization chart where I want to have CEO. In CEO, I want to have some like CFO. I want to have CFO. Then I have some in CFO, I have some GM. I want to have some other things. And he has created a chart by inserting textbook. Then he's creating arrow, then he's creating some other textbook. Then boss says that, okay, I want to put the photographs also. I want to add some new name. I want to remove this person. I want to fire this person. Like, I want to change the hierarchy. Now I want to make him I want to give him promotion. And that person, he's like struggling like anything. Anything he's struggling. Every day, full day, that person job, I have seen myself. Only and only he's creating only organization chart. His only work whole month, that is the organization chart. Because company CEO wants every time that now he wants for branch, now he wants for like finance function, now he wants to do some changes, so like all such type of things. Now some color difference, now sometimes photo. So what to do that? So here if you go, friends, in case of insert. So in case of insert, when you go here, there you are going to find one very fantastic things. And what is this? That is going to save your lot of time. What is that thing? That is the smart art. Where to find that smart art? Let's see. Where is that smart art? You see, here in illustrations, there is lot of things, pictures, shapes, icons. I'm not going all those things. If I'm going to with that, then maybe like till tomorrow, 2 o'clock. So you have to like bear with me. So now this is the smart art. So when I'm going to click this smart art, there are lot of things, lot of processes you want to create that, okay, you want to create process like this. You want to create like this. You want to create like this. So all those things like list, some processes, some cycles, something like you want to create like this. So here, if you say that, okay, this is the my process. So now how is it creating this process is there? Let's try to understand this. So what will happen? So now if you want to change the name, so you say that, okay, I want to have some my process that is like hiring. And I want to give him training. And I want to give him some work. So now such type of process is there. Now you want to see the coloring of this. You want to have like this. Now you want to give some photo also. Now you want to like this also. Now you want to change like this, like in such a way. So you see, it's so easily. You want to change the colors also. So you can change the colors also. You want to change the styles. So you can change the styles. So there are so many ways you can have the power of this, such type of things. Such type of things we generally do in PPT. But that type of things are possible in here also. Now, if you want to add something new, so here is a button. So you go here and you can add in case of work, like work too. Automatically, it will take care. So in the same way, friends, what I can do, I want to create some hierarchy. I want to create some organization chart, which is very, very complicated. I have seen what I can do. Again, I go to insert, I go to illustrations, I go to smart art, and I can say that, okay, hierarchy. And in hierarchy, you will be amazed to see that, okay, I want to have a chart like this organization chart used to show hierarchy information or reporting relationship. Now you have created this chart. Now you want to put here that, okay, this is going to be my CEO. Now you say it is going to be my CFO. You say it is going to be GM. This is you are going to say senior manager. Like that, you say here it is manager. Now you want that, okay, between this CFO, I want some more person. So you go here, enter, or maybe below this CEO, you want something more. So you want CMO. So that CMO is there. Now below CMO, you want something. So you just put enter and put tab. So below CMO, you can create something that, okay, that is the PA to CMO. If you want with GM, you want some more person, you go here, right click, and here you can add shape after below after add assistant. Right click is wonderful key. So here you can put below GM, there is some assistant or executive. Right, in the same way, you say that, okay, we don't need this manager here. You go here and you can say that, okay, I don't need this person. So you just go and delete it. Automatically it will adjust all the heights, it will adjust all the things, it will adjust. So you don't have to worry. But earlier the person used to do the this text box. He used to do lot of manual working. And it's now see the beauty. Once you have created this chart and now you want to present this thing to your boss. So what to do when you are presenting this? So your boss today is wearing some shirt which is on of some different color. So you go here, smart design, and you say that, okay, I want to create like chart like this. Okay, I want to have this color like this. So now when you are going to have like such type of thing, so you can create any type of chart. Here you want to have that, okay, such type of things. Now you want that, okay, I want to create photo also here. I want to put photographs also. So you go here and you can create something. There is a thing which is having the photographs also. So there is a different patterns are there. And in one pattern, yes, this is your thing. And here you can put the photographs also. You go here and maybe on your file, you can put the photographs of Mr. Sai, you can put the photograph of Mr. Deepak, you can put the photograph of Rohit, you can put the photograph of Mr. Babu. So anything, and you never forget to change the color. Whenever you are presenting to your boss, so always remember, always go with some new things. Always we go with some new things so that boss feels, oh yaar, Deepak ji is a very creative person. No, I should not leave this person. This is something fantastic. I should make him the part of our management. So, but all the work, who is doing? Excel is doing. Who is the smart? But just we have to understand that things that, okay, Excel is so powerful, so like good. So we have to understand such type of powers. There are so many things, friends, you will be amazed to know. Just I'm saying that please explore these things. You can create like something like you want that, okay, such type of things. You see how the like person like can ignore such type of presentation? Can anybody ignore such type of things? I can't ignore. I never can think of that, okay, something like if you are going to present something, definitely you are going to be noticed. How your client can go away? He is going to bring you lot of new clients. That definitely is going to happen. Different colors. Deepak ji, do you like this?
Yes.
Your management will like it?
I hope so.
So such type of things actually we can create with the help of like such type of these charts. Now let's move to the other agenda. So this is my first slide actually, which I wanted to share with you. And now there are new functions of Office 365, Excel 2016. So it's not possible that I'm going to have all the functions. But just for your information, these all the functions are going to work in 2016 and few on Office 365 only. And few still are in beta version. So if you are going to have this Office 365 and still also you are saying that, okay, you want to be part of insiders, then only you are going to have some of these functions. So this Concat text join is part of 2016. This is not the beta version. This is the standard Excel. But this unique, this ifs, this command is, I believe that is in 2016. This XLOOKUP, XMATCH, unique and sort, all these are the beta version. But I'm having with me, and these formulas, something like you always dreamed of, you always thought of, right, I want to see like such type of functionality in Excel, and that is there. But maybe after 5 years, after 10 years, like you will say, have some trainings, maybe some Vijay Agarwal, some other like person, and when he's going to tell you, then you will see, oh, this function is for last 10 years. This is function is from since 2007, like I'm telling you today. Are you getting my point? So please explore whenever you are having your latest function, latest Excel. So just go to Google and type, what are the new functions in Excel 2016? What are the new functions in Office 365? What are the new functions in 2013? Just you give one command and believe me, you are going to get so many commands on YouTube, on Excel, this. Just you don't have to spend a lot of time. Just you understand only top 5 things, only top 10 things, and you implement those things. Really, your life is going to be very, very easy. Really, you are going to be like exceptional in your company. So that type of things you have to do. So what this Concat is going to do, what this text join is going to do, let me give some example. Quickly, I'm going to give some example. So I believe we have time till 2:30 now. And the question answer, how much time you want to Deepakji?
Yeah, so we can go ahead for another 20-25 minutes and then we can have Q&A.
Okay, great. So I believe the speed and the way I'm going, so it is like members, if they can put some comments, so is it going fine or something like I want to change, you need me to change, so please tell me, because I'm going in my way.
No, it's going fine, we can continue.
Okay.
And try to cover these, or maybe slicer also if possible.
Yeah, slicers also, that is also a part of this like dashboard. I'm going to show some dashboard slicer also, so that I'll cover in 15 minutes only. So let me give one or two examples of these new functions, right?
Yeah, so the feedback is good. Feedback is good, we are doing fine. Let's continue.
Okay, thank you very much. So friends, there is a function of this text join. What this text join is going to do, I'm going to tell you how this text join is very, very easy, how its text join is going to helpful for me. So let's see this function. So here, what was there? Let's see. You see some example. You'll understand that, okay, what was the problem? And what I want to tell you that, okay, what is there? So I'm having some data. Here I'm having data, I'm having such type of emails. In all these emails, I want to make the emails. If I want to make together all the emails, what I have, generally I do, I need a formula that is a concatenate. And in concatenate, there is a very big disadvantage. That is not something like I can give a range. If I want to give a range, it will not work. That is the biggest disadvantage. For that, I need to do one, again one. So it is going to give me 4 emails together. Still, comma is missing. Still, space is missing. So what I have to do? Again, I have to go to this concatenate and I have to change this to some space and some comma and space. Here I have to go and then again I have to give some space and some comma and space. Like this I have to do. So now it is creating only 2 emails. So like that, if I am having 50 emails, I have to do 50 times. And in between, if some new name comes, if something I am deleting, then again it is going to haywire. There will be some value error, some other errors. So to take care of this, Microsoft has done that. Okay, don't worry. There is two new formulas. Instead of concatenate, there is concat. And for this, you want to put some space, delimiter, there is a formula of the text join. So what the text join is going to do, you go to the text join. Then you are going to have this text join. So you go here, text join. What is the delimiter? You tell it, what is the delimiter? You say that my delimiter is comma and space. Ignore empty. Whether you want to ignore empty, it will automatically ignore empty. Now, what is your text range? You go here and give that text range here. All the range, like you do the sum formula. And once you do it, okay. Immediately, you are going to have all the everything. Now, if you are going to change something, like, okay, you say that, okay, Deepak@gmail.com. It is going to come. If you are going to create some new name also, you go here and you put there sai@hotmail.com. Automatically, you see, Deepak is there, Sai is there. But if you were using concatenate formula, that was not possible. There was a very big pain. So with the help of text join, anything you can do and anything like you can find it out. So now the other formula, very quickly, let me tell you what is the other formula. So this concat and text join is the same family. Then there is a very good formula, that is a unique formula. Unique and the formula, but this is in beta version. That is part of Microsoft Office 365. It is going to make my life very easy. How it is going to work? Let's try to understand. Let's see some business example of that. So what is the example of that? Like, let's see some names or something. Like, I'm having this data here. So I'm having lot of customers. I'm having lot of salesperson. And these salesperson, all these salesperson are coming again and again. I want to create a list of the salesperson who are unique, who are something unique. So in that case, I know there is a formula of remove duplicates. So in that case, what I can do, if I go here, data, if I put here remove duplicates, it can create a list of only the names of unique person. But what happens now if my original list, if I'm going to put, instead of this, I'm going to put some Deepak. If I'm going to put something Rohit, and this Deepak is coming two times, but this list is not appended. Still, I'm having the old list. Again, now I have to take this. Again, I have to remove duplicate. That is not something dynamic. So to make it dynamic, Excel has come with a very wonderful formula, and the formula name is unique. Unique. So how it is going to work? So now you go here. You put formula of unique. You see, unique. Maybe in your laptop it is not there. Maybe only for the person who has Office 365 and the opted for insider version. So you go here, unique, and now you select the range. All the range, 600 lines I have selected. You understand me? And I have put here enter. So once I have put here enter, you see automatically it has come Coolman, Batman, and you see automatically. When I am in Coolman, my formula is visible. When I am on Batman, my formula is visible. But I can't delete this Batman here. If I want to delete something, I can delete only on the top of that. So what I can do here, if this is my something that is amazing. So if I am going to change here, A. If I am going to put here, B. I have created new list. You know, I have created some new list with the name of Sai. And if I'm going to drag it, this is my, the list which we have created with the name of, the name of the this cities. So I have created Dubai. And when I'm going to drag it, so my Dubai is there, Sharjah is there, Ajman is there. And automatically, you see, it is giving me the list of the salesperson or the list of the cities. Now, if I want to add some new city here, now I want to add here, like here, London. Automatically it is adding. If I'm going to add any number of cities here, Mumbai, that is also adding.
And if I'm going to delete some names, that will also go away. So if I go here and I'm going to delete all the names here, you see, only these names. If I'm going to delete these three names also, you see, because I have selected the blanks also, that's why it is giving zero. Otherwise, it is having only Dubai. Again, if Dubai is there, no change. Again, Dubai is there, no change. Again, if I go here, Ajman is there, automatically it will come. So that is the thing, that is a new formula. And it is not only unique. If I want to sort also, there is a formula of the sorting also. Even I can add here, like if I have the, like hold the data. If I want that, okay, I want to sort also. I can put here sorting also. Now it will do fantastic, double, two benefits. It will unique as well as sorted also. So you see, automatically it has sorted as well as the unique also. Now if I'm going to put ZZZ, it will come on the last. Now if I'm going to put after ZZ, AAA, it will come on the top. Automatically it is giving me value of this unique as well as the sort. So these are the new functions of so I'm not having time. That's why I'm not able to show you what is ifs, what is this XLOOKUP. Everything is fantastic. Everything need time. Everything need something. So I suggest that, friends, you please visit my YouTube channel. That is the name of Champ Excel. CHAMP, champion, champion in Excel. So there are
lot of videos. Yes. If we can show ifs one.
Yeah.
Quickly, just ifs, EIF, IFS, ifs.
Yes, yes. Yes, definitely we can do like ifs formula. So, I'm okay. I'm having a lot of time, Deepakji. Today, like, I have kept time only for this Kuwait chapter. Kuwait only.
Thank you.
So, I'm absolutely fine, sir. So, if something like my friends, my colleagues, they like it, so it's my pleasure that, okay, I'm able to tell something. So, let's see that, okay, what is the example of that? What is the ifs formula is there? So, let's take some name. I'm having the name of like these, and I'm bagging it here. So these are the names which I'm having here. So what I want here, I want that, okay, I want to give some marks here. Rand between, I have given some marks 1 to 100. So these are the marks I'm getting it. So now I want that, okay, whoever person, the person who got the marks of more than 80. If a person who has got more than 80, I want to make him pass. So there I need a formula, that is the logical formula. And that formula is of logical. And here is the formula, the name is if. That is very commonly used. If means it is going to see the conditions. It is going to see whether that is true or false. If it is true, what I have to do? If it is false, what I have to do? So here you say that, okay, my logical test is this 62. If it is greater than or equal to 80, and I should make this 80 as a fix, otherwise it will not give result. That is absolute reference. So you have to understand what is absolute, what is relative. Conceptually, friends, if you are going to understand the things, then you are going to love Excel. You are going to save a lot of time. But if you are not going with the concept, not you are going from the base to like top, then it is going to create problem. So always try to understand the concepts. So here value if tree, true, I am saying that it is pass. Otherwise, so now if I'm going to drag this formula, so it is giving me result that, okay, this is pass and this is fail. That is more than 80. If I want to change this 50, it is going to give me result more than 50 or automatically. But sometimes what happens, I want that, okay, if someone who has got greater than 80, I want to give excellent. If he has got something 60 to 80, I want to give very good. Something 30 to 60, I want to say that, okay, fair. And 0 to 30, I want to give poor. So if I want to give such type of conditions, 4 categories, 5 categories, 10 categories, 20 categories, I want to give. So hypothetically, I am giving right now only 4 categories. But practically, there may be lot of categories. So in that case, friends, if you don't know Excel, or maybe in the older version, it is a little complicated. That is called nested if. If, again, inside if, again inside if, again inside if. And if something, someone is going to see that formula looks like something like this. So that formula is like this. If H1, 2 like something, again if, again if, again if, again if, again if. And something is going to be difference, then automatically like this, everything will go in toss. If boss is saying that, okay, from tomorrow, I want to have some new category also. So he say that, okay, I want instead of 30 to 60, I want some new category there. So he say that, okay, new category there. That is 60 to 75. That is only good. And here you are saying that, okay, this is my 75 to. So if such type of difference are there, then it was very, very problematic. So for that, Microsoft Excel has come with a new formula, and that is with the if, there is a ifs formula. Like if you remember, some if formula was there till 2013, 2003. Now it is some ifs. There was count if. Now it is count ifs. There is multiple conditions. So in the same way, we can have multiple conditions of ifs here. So how this ifs is going to work? So quickly, I'm going to tell you. So please, you try to understand. This is greater than 80. This is greater than, let's move, only four conditions. So you are saying that greater than, this is 60. This is greater than 30. This is greater than 0. So I'm going to use like this. And I say that, okay, ifs formula. In case of ifs, I'm saying that, okay, if this number is greater than 80, right? So I'm saying that, what is my condition? First condition, that is excellent. Now, automatically, I don't need the other formula. I can see like logical test one, value is true. Now the second logical test, I say that C3 greater than is 60. And I say that, okay, then I want good. Then again, comma, and where also I should make this fix. Not this fix, I should make this H2 fix, H3 fix. And the third one, I say that, okay, if that is C3 greater than this 30, then I want fair, that is this. And after that, I say that, okay, if this C3 is greater than 0, I want here over. So these type of formulas, if I have put, so now I am saying that, okay, what will be the result? So it is seeing excellent, good, poor, fair, everything it is coming. And what is the very small formula? If you are going to understand this formula, let me open this. There is a very, very small, like the things. First logical test, C3 greater than F2. F2 means if it is greater than 80, what should be the result? So I am telling it that, okay, if that is the So if that is the case, so I am telling this that, okay, if you see, if I am going to have this first condition, so that true, so I need this H2. If the second condition, that is true, so I want that, okay, if that is greater, I want good. If that is the third condition, I want this. So it will go into priority. First, it will see greater than 80. If that is true, it will write excellent. Then it will go to the second condition. Then it will. So it is very easy to maintain. So that is the about the ifs formula. So I hope like you are able to understand. But friends, I'll say that it needs practice. It is like swimming. So by seeing, you feel that, okay, it is very easy. But when you go to water, when you start swimming, you remember your mummy, papa, everything like you are going to remember. Then you feel that, okay. But I'm sure that if you are going to do little practice as early as possible, then it is going to be ever for you. Then you are going to remember it forever. So these were the formulas which I wanted to convey. And now quickly, let me go to the dashboard. That is something very, very amazing. I'm having the quick file with me, and how this dashboard looks like, how we can see, how we can analyze our data. So dashboard is a new term. Sometimes like we are having data, like if you see here, I'm having a data. So in this data, friends, what is there? Right now, I'm having the column of order ID. I got some order. This is my order date. This is my customer ID. This is my customer name. Here is the salesperson who is handling this particular company or the customer. Here is the region. Like in that case, in your case, it can be country also. In your case, you are some branch also. So product name, what is the product name? What is the category of that product? What is the unit price, quantity, and the revenue? Based on this, if something you want to analyze the data, and believe me, like that analysis is not something like very, it is very, within 10 minutes, within 15 minutes, you can create a fantastic dashboard. And dashboard, it is not something one time dashboard, like only for company. It is interactive dashboard. Like anything, if you are going to change, immediately it is going to provide you some like answer for that. And how that type of dashboard looks like, I show you the dashboard, and then I tell you how this type of dashboard is being created. So if you go this dashboard, let me hide these headings also, grid lines also. So if you see, this looks like something like very great. You see, this is the dashboard. So here in this dashboard, that is the same data. I'll show you how to create this dashboard. Don't worry. Right? Maybe like if Deepakji or our chairman is going to give me opportunity like later. So if he's going to ask me that some more program, then I love to do it for my friends in Kuwait. So definitely, but it depends on your management, your like. So what we can do?
Vijayji, we can give next 15-20 minutes on Slicer and this dashboard, and we can skip the Q&A because this is important and people are liking it. There are not many questions so far, so we can address the questions subsequently for the members. We can collect all the Q&A and then send it to you, and in WhatsApp we can forward them. So let's focus this on Slicer and dashboard for the next 20 minutes.
So like if like my members, my friends are ready, so maybe we can extend for 10 minutes, 15 minutes for Q&A also. That also I'm fine.
No problem. Okay.
Okay. So I also want to tell them that, okay, how this dashboard is made. So this is the dashboard, friends, I have made with the data, and I'll show you how easy it is to make. So now what is the like benefit of this dashboard? This dashboard we take from the automobile industry. Like while we are driving our car, we are in the control of our this car. So we know what speed we are going, how much petrol we are having. We know how the like our this cooling system is working. So everything is in our control, and anything I can change, I can switch to the some other music. I can control the speed. All those type of things, I can control the temperature. So in the same way, you are having this data. That data, like I told you, it makes sense. So you are having also such type of data. Your sales book type of thing is there. Order sheet is there. So now you want to analyze your this data, right? So no need of your person. If you next 15 minutes, you will be able to make this chart. Believe me. So now this dashboard. So now you want to see, this is for whole company. Now you want to see only for North region. So you click it, and this chart is giving you performance for North only. Your North region, how the sales tracking is going on, how this sales wise salesperson, how top five customers are doing, what is the count of transaction by invoice amount, what is sales by region, and what is sales by product, what is the sale of coffee, what is the sale of chocolate, beer. Now you want to see, like in North, there are two salesperson. One is Akshay, one is Katrina. You want to see performance of Akshay. You click it, you see the performance of Akshay. So Akshay has sold total of 1,04,000. This is the trending. January, his favorite dip down, and like this, he's doing very well in December. That is 16K, because he need increment. He need a good appreciation. So he's going from 6K, he has reached to 16K. So now, if you want to see for all, so this is the whole. Now you want to see only for this Rekha. So this is the only for Rekha. You want to say for Salman. This is for Salman. This is for Shahrukh. So this is for Shahrukh. So it is also showing me. So like multiple also you can see, single also you can see. So now it depends on you. Right. Right now, I am having data for 1 year. If you are having data for 2 years, 3 years, so I can put a this here the something that for year also, and you can select here year also that okay, what is the performance of in 2010? What is the performance in the, like 2019 or what is the performance in 2020? That is also possible, very easily possible. That also I can do. So how this is done? Let's move to that. Let's see that magic. How we can do that magic? So let's see. So friends, what I am going to do for your reference, I am going to copy this data for a new sheet. So there is no like placing of data is there. So I have taken to the new workbook. This is my new workbook and this is my chart. So let's see and let's try to create this chart. How to understand the this? What is this? These are called slicers. What is that timeline? That also I tell you how to make such type of beautiful chart. So this is our data. So all these dashboards are possible with the help of pivot table only, friends. Only pivot table. Pivot table again is a wonderful thing that I say that okay, something very like easy and but very very powerful. One of the best like I can say of the like tool of the pivot table. Here you don't need any formula, you don't need any technical knowledge. You have some data, only you have to ensure that your data is having header, your data is connected, you are having all the revenue, only amounts, values in your date, only dates. In case of your region, like you are having like the proper like things. So it's not that somewhere you are having chocolate and other where you are having chocolates. So for Excel, those will be two products. Chocolate is different and chocolates is different. So that type of things you have to maintain. Like if something like you have, you are having one is Salman and the other you are having Salman Khan. So those are 2% for Microsoft Excel. So those type of things like you have to ensure before making the pivot table or dashboard. So now once you are here, you go here insert and you go here pivot table. Automatically there is no need to select the data. I have seen people they select the data, but Excel is so powerful. Excel is so like intelligent. It understands till where your range is there. You see, I didn't select the data, but Excel understood that my data is till 372 rows, but this can be 3 lakhs rows also. Now I told it what is my new worksheet. I want to have this report on new worksheet. I said that yes, I want it new worksheet. Okay, so now this is okay. Now let's see what I want first. I want to see sales by salesperson. So what I'll see salesperson, I can drag salesperson to sales rows. And I want to see the revenue. I can put here, this is the value. This is the value of like my revenue. So once this value is there and I can create when I am here pivot table analysis and I said can say pivot chart. And this chart also I see like what type of chart actually I'm looking for. Let's see in my other file friends. So this is the bar chart. This is called bar chart. But it's your choice. I'm not saying that you should go with bar chart. I liked something like this. That's why I created like this. The color combination, anything, it depends on you. So here you go and you say that, okay, pivot table analysis and you go pivot chart and you say that bar chart and you create it. This is my bar chart. So you don't want this total, you remove this. You don't want this total, you remove this. You don't want this line, you remove it. You don't want this hide value field, so you remove it. You don't want hide this old field button, so you remove it. So like that you have made. You also see here that okay, how looks sales by salesperson. So something like if you want to put the header also, so you can go here and you can create some that okay, I need some books also where I want to write. You want to change the color, so you go here and you say that okay, what type of color combinations you want here. So you say that okay, I need something like chart like this, and here some bigger box you want. So you see that okay, where the bigger box is there. So this whether you like this or this, so it will depend. I believe this is good. So now you are having this chart. You go here, right click, and you that at data levels also. So now I have put data levels. So now with this currency, anything you can change anytime. So you say that, okay, now you want to see that, okay, top to bottom. You go here, right click, and you say that sort largest to smallest. So automatically by chart or smallest to largest, so that also it will take care. So it is my top to bottom. This is me showing me chart. And something like the same type of colors also you want. So friends, that also is possible here. This line I want to delete, and I am going to select. So maybe like we can see. So now this is the chart, and these are the names which I have put. And if I want to make it little smaller, so I can make it smaller also. If I want to change the color also, so I can go here and I can make some color. That's something amazing. Okay, very good, excellent. And I want to remove this, I can remove this. So this one chart I have created here, and I want to add the name of also, that is the design. I add chart element, I chart title, I say that chart title above the chart. And here I want to put, that is the sales by salesperson. So I go here and I put sales by sales. So why I'm taking time? Because once one chart you have made, now your life is going to be easy. So first you create chart like this, that is your good chart. So now what you can do, you change this rename, that is the salesperson. And now you take, you copy the sheet immediately. How you can copy it? There are two ways to copy the sheet. One is the right click, move or copy, and you can create a copy. The second, which I like you do the control, you are writing handed, and if you want to copy this, while you are dragging, press control key. This is copied. While you are dragging, press control key. In the same way, when you are dragging this, press control key. One new sheet is there. And you change the name of this sheet, salesperson. Here you put the product. So now what we have to do with this product, because my chart is ready, everything is ready, and here I have to go, and instead of salesperson, what I can change, friends, I remove this and I can put region, maybe like product if I want to have. So let's take the product. So where is the product? Product name is there. So this is my, all the products are there. You see, again I can sort this data. So that is there. And here I can change this sales by salesperson. So I can sales by product. So this is my second chart is also there. The formatting or grouping like that I can change. So if you go here, so you see this is my chart, the second chart here. So I can also have made this chart. The color, something like, if you like that, okay, I want to make the same type of color. So you go here and you select this chart and make the same colors, something. Such type of charts, and you have created some color. In the same way, you create a copy of this, and now you go here and change the name. They are sales by the top five customers. So top five customers means, so here you go, rename top five. And here you can do, instead of there, you remove this product, and now salesperson you put here. So now all the salesperson are there, but I want only top five. You go here and you go here top 10. Instead of top 10, you select only top five. That is top five. Again, you sort it and you say that, okay, these are my top five. Again, you go here, something, the color which you like, that, okay, I want some blue color. So you, something you change, this is my blue color. So this is my top five customers. I can see the size, what type of size actually I want. So that type of things I can create. This is my sales by product. So now I want sales by region. So very easy. Now once you have made something and you put here region, so this is my sales by region. Okay, and in region I want not a bar, I want column wise. You go here, design and change this, change chart type, and you say that I want column wise chart. So this is your column wise chart. This amount you can change, okay, what type of thing you want, whether that is in the value, that should be the decimal. So everything is there, but because of time constraint, I'm not going. So here you can put sales by region. That is there. So in the same way, one you can create sales trend. So sales trend, how you can create? So let's see, again, you copy this and rename and you put here trending. So in case of trending, you want that, okay, what is the trending in the month wise? So what you can put here, your order date. When you are going to put order date here, by default, if you are having the latest version, automatically it will convert it into month. But your older version, if you are having the 2007, 10 or 13, so maybe this will not possible. In your case, it will show like this. How it is going to show you? So let me tell you. So it is going to show like this. All the dates will be appear and this chart will be there, and you will say, oh, that is not possible. But friends, there is a fantastic this command. This is lying for last 15 years since 2007. When you go to this date, I have seen people spending their nights, their days, their weeks. And if you go here to make it weeks, to make 2 weeks, months or quarters or years, right click here, group. And immediately you say that, okay, month wise, this is the report month wise. You want a note month wise, you want to quarter wise, you go here, quarter wise report is there. You won't need both quarter wise as well as month wise also. That is also possible. You see, this is your quarter one, quarter two. So it's such type of report also you can create that, okay, I want quarter one, quarter two. So it depends on you, how you are going to have this type of things. Now you have data like this. Again, you sort that, okay. No, now you don't have to sort because this is January, February. But in case of trending, it is always good to show as a line chart. So you go here, design, change chart type, and you say that, okay, I want some line chart. So this is the line chart has been created. So here you say that, okay, that is my trending. So now this is a trending. Now you want, okay, some colors also, something like, so those are something like very, very small things that, okay, you want to have like such type of chart or something like this, or like if you have made this, if you want to change some colors also, so very easily you can change colors also. So those are, I believe, very, very small things which everybody knows that, okay, how to make our charts or life easy or good. So this is my trending. So now this is ready. I can delete this exige here. So this is a thing I have made. Now let's go to the move to the dashboard, and I'm creating one more sheets, and this is something like rename, that is the dashboard. Let me save my file. This is the mistake generally most of the people they do. I'm also doing this file and Kuwait dashboard. So I am making this dashboard for Kuwait. So I have made this. So now I can do that. Okay, first I can have this trending. I can copy also, I can cut also. It depends on me whether I want to copy. Let's copy. It should keep here also and there also. I can put here this dashboard, that is the trending. So I can put here like this. This is my something dashboard. So how it is looking like? So I should make little lower. I can close this. So this is my trending this dashboard. So now I move to the other sales by salesperson. So that is the salesperson. I take it control C dashboard and I come here control V. And let's move view. I don't want to see the grid lines. I don't want to see the headers. So that type of things I am doing. So this is my sales by salesperson. Now again, let's move. I want to see sales by region. I went here region and I selected it, control C dashboard. I went here, control V, this is my dashboard. Now again, I went here. I want to see top five customers. So I have selected these top five customers control C and control V. If I want to see that something like I can select, and if I want to make some size little small, so I can make a little so that it is coming in single page. You see, it is coming in single page. So now I want to have that, okay, I need like here the product also. So I went here and I told that, okay, I need product. I copy this. I went to the dashboard and here I sent control V. And I can drag it because there are a lot of products are there. So there, like we have to see as per our requirement. So this is my sales rep product. Here I want something like I want to play with my dashboard. So I can go here anywhere on this pivot chart analysis. There is an insert slicer. I want to insert slicer based on the salesperson, based on the region. So I have selected two things, salesperson and region. So these are the, this is the region, this is the salesperson. I can select more also. I can select this also. Here I have selected region and salesperson. Suppose I want to select the timeline also. There is a timeline feature is also there. I want to see quarter wise or year wise also. So what I can go here. So that is something, everything you should try. Here you can put insert timeline. So this is order date. You put here. So automatically it has put an this order date. But because we are having only 1 year, so instead of that, months, let's see for the quarter. Color and feel also, this timeline color feel. So I can say that, okay, I want to see like this color. Here I want to see that, okay, some different color. And that should be like this. Here I want to see something different color, slicer. And I want to see something like this. So this type of color we have made. Right. Now let's see. When I'm going to select this north region, only one chart is changing. No other chart are changing. Right. How to make that all chart are changing. So now we have to see the Guru Mantra. That is the right click. You go to right click, you see the power of right click. Here you will find that, okay, there is a button report connection. Right now, this report is connected only with one pivot table. That is the trend. I want to connect this to the all the charts connected. In the same way, I go here. It depends on you that where you want to connect it. And here I have gone here and the connection that is there. In the same way, I go here, report connection. I can click this, that. So it depends on me that, okay, I want to see connection for all, or maybe if I don't want to connect for the trending, so I can put here without trending also. It depends on me. So now that is there. Now everything is ready. My this dashboard, that for big four companies, they are going to charge you 1 million. 1 million, maybe, or in Indian currency, maybe INR. But that I'm telling you within 10 minutes with the help of your great chapter, with the help of your chairman, great chairman, vice chairman, Deepak ji, with the Mr. Sai. And so now if you want to see the North region, you want to see only for Akshay, only for Krishma. Now you want to see only for quarter two, only quarter four. All you want to see for all. This is for all. You want to see two quarters, quarter three and quarter four. So you select it, quarter three and quarter four. You want to see last three quarters, all the quarters. That is also possible. So that is the all, like I'll say. And this type of charts, this is very, very small chart dashboard. I can show you some files which I have created for my clients. Those are something amazing. You will never believe that, okay, this is something in Excel. Oh, this you have done for your clients. So like such type of things, friends, I have done for my clients. I'm taking projects for my clients. I'm saying that your 7 days work, I can convert into 1 hour, half an hour. I'm doing trainings for my like people. So I say that within 2 days, 10 days, your life, you can become basic to advanced. So such type of courses, like if you want to know, you can visit my website, you can visit my YouTube channel. If you want to further gain the knowledge, please subscribe my YouTube channel. That is the Champ Excel, CHAMP, Champ Excel. And if you need any type of products, so these type of utilities already I'm giving free of cost to all of you. And that is the thing that, okay, merge all files of a folder on real time. So this utility is like free, that is lying on my YouTube channel. You can download it. You can see video is there. GSTA 2A 3B reconciliation for India. So this is like free utility is available on my YouTube channel. GST number finder. With your PAN number, you can find the GST number without any help of a portal, without anything. I have created that GST number finder. I have sent this file to Deepakji also. Few of these files. So maybe the Deepakji is going to select and share this file to all of your members. Something still you want, whether you want this dashboard which I have created, this dashboard or some other dashboard, that also I'll be happy to share. No, nothing like knowledge, as much you are going to share, that as much you are going to gain. I have learned from you people only. If you are going to ask question, then only I'm getting such type of knowledge. So billing for small business, that is also one utility. Auto indexing, convert SMS to table. Yesterday only I have created a YouTube video. How to, I'm getting the SMS and I want to convert that SMS into a table. So that I have made like a utility type of things. So this file also I'm going to share with you friends. So when you go, so you see, I'm getting, this was the scenario, I'm getting this SMS and how to convert this SMS into a, this is the scenario. One chartered accountant asked me and his say was, he wanted that once he's going to create this SMS here, automatically this is going to create that this tabular form. Single cell, this is the new message. If I'm going to do copy and if I go here and put here, automatically my solution is ready. So this type of scenarios, this type of projects I'm taking for my, doing for my clients. I'm my big four is my client. I'm having clients all over the India. So I love to connect with you in any respect, any way. If, I would love to connect with you. And I'm really sorry that I couldn't take your question answer, but still I have time. 10 minutes, 15 minutes, 20 minutes. It depends on you. But I know everybody has commitment. We have time till 2:30 only. And really, I'm very, very thankful to our chairman, sir, Mr. Sai, and also Deepak ji, Rohit. So who is managing all these things for last 2 days. I'm also having the interaction with a lot of practice. This testing session we have done. And that's why we are here. We are here to deliver. And perfectly, it is going fine. And that is all from my side. Thank you very much from India, from Delhi. And if something like I have done some mistake, so really I'm apologize for that. It was not my intention. So please, you are like something like if you want to suggest something so I'll improve in my future sessions. So once again, thank you, thank you, thank you.
Vijay, really appreciate your efforts. And I will like to announce to all the participants, you can see Vijayji's YouTube channel. You can go to his channel. There are many videos on various functions and utilities. His website name is also there, champexcel.com. There are a lot of good videos and programs are there. Vijayji is a trainer. He conducts a lot of training programs. So, Vijayji, what I understand from you is that Excel is like an ocean and you have deep dived into the ocean and brought the pearls for us. So you did the hard work and you have given us a lot of pearls on the platter to us. We will definitely use all these pearls to make our life better and fast and efficient. Really appreciate your time and efforts, and on a very short notice you agreed to do this webinar for us. And I will hand over this now to our chairman Sai. Sai, if you would like to add anything. This Q&A we could not take, but I have got some Q&A, which whatever members have asked, we will try to get it from Mr. Vijay, all the answers, and send it to each participant individually.
I'm not able to see the video. Like, can you like make me to see the video?
One second. You should be seeing. Actually, we should be able to see you, but yes, we cannot see you.
No, but I'm not able to see your video, please.
Mine?
Yeah, your video also I'm not able to see.
Okay. I think this is something technical. Anyway.
If the video is on, actually, then you can see, because I am able to see Sai and Deepak's video.
No, but what I have to do? Can you tell me?
That videos, if it is like cross, you have to uncross that. Then only you can
see. Yeah, I am doing uncross, but it is not allowing me. Three times, like when I am doing this, so it is going again to unmute like that.
Okay. So might be some connectivity.
Yeah.
Okay. Please go ahead.
Yeah, thanks, Mr. Vijayji. Really appreciate for your fabulous time and taking us the dive into the Excel magic. And really, I sat with my daughter to teach her also, to show her what exactly Excel is doing. It's not me only. So I sat with my daughter and showed your entire training. A really fabulous time we had. But I would like to take one question and answer if you have time of 1 or 2 minutes.
I don't have I have lot of time, plenty of time. Please go ahead.
There was a question from our CA chapter, Mr. Rabin. If Excel has too many magical functions, in your opinion, you don't require any expensive reporting software, which for every change you have to pay huge customization cost. What is the reason why we have Excel such a beautiful software?
Like I say that when the other softwares work finish, then the work of Excel starts. So ending is always in Excel. So something like if you want to make the entry, like Excel can't replace SAP. Excel can't replace Tally, because those are the entry software. They're like something, everything is keep recording. Like we can have the tracking also, like who has done like something, who has changed something. We can control all those things. So this Excel is something like very, very user friendly. So here, once we have the data, so how to handle that data, how to create reports, how to make some presentations. So all those type of things we can do with the help of Excel without spending any much money. But if you are having a big company, obviously you are having the stock things. So how like in Excel, you can handle all like stocks. Maybe like small company, he can handle the stocks in Excel. But something like the softwares which are having the functionality like Tally. So I'll say that, okay, Tally is like, even you forget about the Tally, even the Word, Microsoft Word can't replace Excel. Excel can't replace Word. So something like those type of things, like those type of things, all are independent. But yes, for our accountants, as an accountant, as a chartered accountant, like the whatever business or the practice we are doing. So this is our one of the best friend, I can say. And the as much knowledge we are going to have, the more we are going to earn, the more you are going to keep our time like spare. We can give more time to our family. So that is the thing I'll say.
Yeah, that's true. Understood. So basically, it all depends on the type of organization and the complexity of the organization structure and in terms of the transactions. Yeah, definitely your answer is very valuable. I think it's a time to wind up the session. On behalf of the ICA Kuwait chapter, I really appreciate your time and efforts. So please accept our kindest gratitude and best wishes. And we hope to see you much, much more sessions in the future like this. I think we got almost already... Yeah, we already got so many requests saying that can we have phase 2, phase 3 and everything. So I think we need to have this sort of momentum going forward. Really, thanks for your time once again. Thanks a lot.
And also I suggest like all the friends that, okay, you must visit my website, that is Champ Excel, and the YouTube channel Champ Excel, and please subscribe it. There are some videos in Hindi also, Hindi and English, but I believe there should not be any problem to understand the things. And also sometimes I'm having in my channel some master products, some very master class, that type of a product is there. So like how to do the mastery on a pivot table, how to do the mastery in text formula, how to do automation mastery. So those are available as a video, like such type of things. So such type of things, if you are going to have, definitely it is going to give a lot of edge to your professor. So that's a request to all my friends.
we will share, if we can share the contact and if you can share the this entire Excel sheet, the one which you did the worksheet, and as well as the content.
Already I have shared, and the already like my this PPT I have shared this again. I'm sharing. This is my phone number, yes. WhatsApp number, and this is my YouTube channel and the my website, that is the Champ Excel. So please visit here. And also any question, so whether related to today's session or other session also, other things also, I'll be happy to answer. So please mail me and I'll give as per my convenience.
Okay, sir. Thanks a lot, Mr. Vijay. Really appreciate it.
Thank you, Mr. Vijay. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thanks, Deepak, for introducing.
Thank you. All the team, and thank you very much all the participants for your valuable time. To have such a wonderful opportunity you have given to me, and you have like response I'm getting. So the participants, that till the first minute and the last minute, all the participants are there. So that is the like the thing. It's give me a lot of satisfaction.
And moreover, the NASA and ISRO, the examples are very it's very funny, and you know, it is
interesting.
Interesting, and you know, it was. So it you created a story around, so it is easy for us to connect to you. Thanks.
Welcome, sir. Welcome.
Thanks so much.
Thank you. Thank you. Bye.
Bye.
Thank you all the participants. Thank you all the participants. Bye.
Thank you, everyone. Thanks for your time and everything. Thank you, Rohit.